Hi everyone and welcome to installing a newer kernel on Debian 10, also known as Buster. In this video, we will have a look at how we can install a newer kernel in Debian 10. Buster is the most recent stable version of Debian. With all updates installed currently, you end up with kernel version 4.19, as you can see. When having a look at the latest kernel version on Kernel Newbies, we can see this version was released more than 2 years ago. Although it does get patches and bug fixes, new features are not all added. Here we can also look at what's included in newer kernel releases, for example 5.9. While the idea of using Debian stable is to remain stable and rather conservative, there are several benefits or reasons to install a newer kernel. In some cases, it's the only option to get the operating system to support all your hardware, which is the main reason to consider an upgrade. The easiest way to install a new kernel is to install it from the backports repositories. These are taken from the next.testing release and backported for use on the current stable release. In order to install a kernel from the backports, we first need to add the backports repository for your Debian version to etc apt-sources.list. Once we save the file, we can update to include the backports in the list of available packages. Now we can list the available kernel images. As you can see, there is a large variety of options. Most of the times you will see the image names having suffixes. The RT suffix stands for real time and is mostly interesting for embedded projects or machines that will drive industrial hardware. DBG stands for debugging and BPO is for a standard kernel from backports. This is what we need. We can also list only the available kernel images for a specific version, for example 5.9. Or we can have a look at the output from aptitude, which gives a better overview. In order to install the latest version which is available in backports, we can simply run apt upgrade specifically for the backports repo. As you can see, this includes a kernel upgrade to 5.9. Once the installation is done, a reboot should bring back the system with the new kernel installed. In case you would like to install a specific version, you can simply list them, then install the version of your choice, for example 5.8. Again, after the installation, we can perform a reboot. At boot time, in the grub boot menu, you can go to advanced options and select which of the installed kernels to use. This method can also be used in case you experience issues with a specific version. Once our system booted, we can see that our choice is the kernel that is currently running. Finally, in order to list the installed kernels, we can check this with dpkg. And if you're happy with the currently running kernel or installed versions, we can do a little cleanup by removing unused versions. As you can see, this removes the kernel version from the system and it is no longer available in the boot menu as well. This concludes my video about upgrading to a newer kernel in Debian 10. Thanks a lot for watching. If you liked it, please put a thumbs up, and if you're interested in this or similar content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel. I also have a Linux-related blog, jensd.be, for which I provided the link in the description. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you back here soon.